There are a lot of interesting, a good point in LR in chapter 2, but you did not import it to support your RQ in chapter 1. That is partly what Dr. Salma was saying just now. So you need to read again what are the important things that you can support your RQ, RO. They are everywhere in chapter 2. But again, you need to aid the local context. Yeah, the best phrase, that Dr. Salma shared with us just now is that you are master of your study. This is PhD. PhD is about you are going to become the reference. The reference when people talk about incubator scheme. But the way I read your thesis is that you are still in the, I don't know what is in English, kepompong. You are still in the kepompong of traditional ways of how the entrepreneur can be succeed in their business lah. In which, this is my opinion, in which you are looking at incubator scheme as the solution. So, but no worry, that is the analogy. The analogy that I have with your thesis lah, but you still can improve it based on Dr. Salma's ideas, comments, as well as my additional input lah. So, looking at this framework, since this framework already in the screen kan, Hidayat, when we look at your framework here, that differentiate whether you are doing master thesis or PhD thesis. That is actually what Dr. Salma is trying to point out. Okay, when we look at this, this is actually a straightforward relationship framework. Okay, there is no element of PhD in this framework actually. So that is the ideas that Dr. Salma is trying to say to you lah, which I understood. So you just improve it. It's very, very, very plain. Very plain. Okay, everybody knows about this without looking at literature. Everyone know about this relationship. So that is what actually Dr. Salma is pointing out just now. You already have the ideas, but how to make it a PhD framework? Macam tu. Infrastructure. Dia simple, sangat simple. In fact, this is what I'm going to comment for the rest of chapters, especially in chapter 5 later on. Yeah. You use a lot of single themes, single words in your PhD, okay, your thesis. Okay, so of that hypothesis development, what you did is that you just mentioned all the authors, the scholars, without explaining it in concisely in detail. Because you should know the difference between the LR discussion and hypothesis discussion, yeah. So in LR discussion, we read whether we include whether the LR support or not support. We include everything, as long as it talks about the focus of the studies. We are yet making any decision. That is what we do in LR. But towards hypothesis development, we still using that LR. But we choose the one that actually suit our context of predicting the outcome of the thesis actually. But we cannot, I say that we cannot use those not supportive. We still use those supportive, but the reason why you use it, why we still use this variable because of this based on the context. So meaning to say your hypothesis development should be, should be something in it, not only mentioning the name of the authors. Yeah, you got this, Dayat kan? Dapatkan maksudnya itu.
Dapat apa?
So you suit your context, whether positive or negative. Yeah, and then because later on, you must remember chapter 1 we have RQ, RO. Chapter 2, chapter 3 combined we have hypothesis, and last chapter we have the contribution of the study supported by this actually hypothesis, supported or not supported. Yeah, and then I go by page lah before I go to the could be negative or positive. Okay, in the target population, page 83. My experience reading a lot of thesis nowadays kan, Hidayat, some students, they still under that 2020 vision. They are still living in that 2020 vision, but now we are already in 2021. For example, my point here is that when you did your PhD, I think maybe 4 years ago or 3 years ago, that time we still not, you know, not approaching the context whereby a lot of things change. For example, incubator in 90s, we don't have ICT, but now we have ICTs. So because of that, maybe the reason incubator is not the right choice. For example, because nowadays people like sitting at home, the new norm incubator can be from YouTube, for example. Okay, there are many ways actually. So that's one of the ideas I got from Dr. Salma just now lah. Why actually is incubator is the only way to make the early startup succeed in their business, or there is another way? Because nowadays the new norm, COVID-19, past 2020, actually there are so many ways on how to make sure that the entrepreneur, early startup, they don't have to go out from their home as well. Work from home, for example. So these are the current things. These are the current things. I believe this one should be included in your chapter 5 later on conclusion.
Yeah.
Just make sure when you do the sampling, kan? You know what is the right numbers for the node, what is the right number for the
sample.
Because the context of environment is different now between these regions. For example, when we talk about Sabah, maybe it somehow kan in your thesis too, you could include the word town, main town, city, for example. Because when we talk about Sabah, it's only about Tawau, Sandakan, and Kota Kinabalu, for example lah. Because these are the places, I think we don't have incubator in Sandakan or Tawau, maybe in Kota Kinabalu, for example. So these are all the little things that you must have good insight of it, because you are going to be referred later on tau. Okay, when you talk about north, which part of north? Is it Alostar? Is it Georgetown? For example, you are referring to the location of the incubator, kan? Betul tak? So this is, you need to include these very little things in order for your thesis have integrity lah about incubator scheme.